And I wonder what they thought about me. Was I squandering my education? Was I squandering my abilities?
All right, one last question, because we have just a couple minutes left. How would you encourage the mom who feels like she's just, she's missing out on something? She's missing out on her career that she's worked so hard for, you know, and I've known plenty of people like yourself who, you know, they are doctors, they are lawyers, they are engineers. You know, they've worked really hard to, you know, they've been teachers, they've worked hard to become successful in the career path that they feel like the Lord has chosen for them. And they've put that to the side in order to be home with their kids and raise their families and homeschool their kids. But I still think a lot of moms feel like they're somehow missing out on something. Like, you know, they're just like, yeah, this is great and I love it, but they just feel like they're being pulled a little bit more towards, you know, what their other passion is. How can you encourage that mom?
I think that it is important for us to, again, remember that there's no just and there's no wasted information, education, and energies. If you had a career as a lawyer before and you stopped doing that because you want to be home with your children, or you're working part-time or whatever it is, you're not sidelined. You're not missing the boat. You're not, and I can say that confidently, because if you're being called to homeschool, then God has that for you now, and not insert career right now.
Right.
So he's going to use those skills in some other way. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's your logic skills and your thinking skills. Maybe it's your organization ability. Maybe it's your communication skills in some other way. And it may not be career. It may not be in a career. It may be, but it may not be. It may be something else, because we're not just a homeschool mom. We're not because our children, you know, Lord willing, we educate them, we train them, we raise them, and they launch. Mm-hmm. And there will be a season, Lord willing, that you are on the other side of that. And that's a big chunk of your life. It's not all of your life.
Yeah.
But it's part of it. So when you're feeling like I struggled with that. I had this degree. I had published research on shark behavior. I was like, career was moving up and it was so fun and I loved it. And then I left to stay home. And I almost felt like my parents, and I wonder what they thought about me. Was I squandering my education? Was I squandering my abilities? And they never said it outright. They're so gracious, but I saw them, because they even thought we were weird when we homeschooled.
Right.
But they started catching the vision when they saw some of the results of what we were doing.
Yeah.
And they became our greatest cheerleaders for homeschooling as they began to see our children develop. And so I was confident that they didn't feel like that, but I felt like that still. And then I started seeing, okay, Lord, what do you have for me? Today you have this for me. I don't know what you have tomorrow.
Yep.
I'm going to pray about it tomorrow. I don't know what you have next month. And so keep an eye out for opportunities. Ask God to show you. Talk to people in your church who are a season ahead of you that are wise, that you admire, and share those. Share your heart. Share your heart with some other moms you can walk alongside with. You may have a desire to, I don't know, start some great business, and it may not be the time right now. So you're starting to gather the experience, the exposure, the information now, until it's time for you to launch that when your children launch.